Hello, my name is Freddy Hurkmans. Today I will explain what bit manipulation is and how it works in C. If you work with hardware, there comes a time you'll have to set or reset a bit in a register, or you might have to invert a bit or perhaps read the status of one bit. In this film I'll explain how this works. Let me start with explaining which bitwise operators we have. These are bitwise AND, bitwise OR, bitwise exclusive OR, and bitwise invert. Please note, these bitwise operators are rather different from the ones you already know. These normal operators work on a variable as a whole. For instance, I have variables A with value 3 and B with value 18, and I write down A and B. Your computer will now check if A and B are true or false. In C, and also C++, value 0 is false and all the rest is true. So both A and B are true. So our statement is really true and true, which is true. A variable as a whole is either false, 0, or true, non-zero. I'll explain in a minute how these operators work. For those of you who are not familiar with AND, OR, exclusive OR, and invert, I will first explain what these functions do. I'll explain these functions by using a truth table. In this case, I use a truth table with two inputs, as that's relevant for what we are doing here. Those inputs are A and B, and both can be 0 or 1. When I fill in this truth table for the AND operator, I must know that the result of AND is 1 if all inputs are 1. In this case, all inputs are A and B, and here both are 1. This result will therefore be 1. In all other cases, either A or B or both inputs are 0, so the result will be 0. To make life a bit easier, later on I'll put a neat version of this truth table on screen, so I can erase my writing without problems. Now we can fill in this truth table for the operator OR. The result of OR is 1 if any input is 1. In this case B is 1, here A is 1, and here both A and B are 1. In this case all inputs are 0, so this result is 0. We can also fill in the truth table for an exclusive OR. The result of an exclusive OR is 1 if exactly one input is 1. In this case neither is 1, so the result is 0. In this case both inputs are 1, so the result is 0. And here only A is 1, so the result is 1. And here only B is 1, so the result is 1. Finally, the invert operator. Invert only has 1 input. 0 inverted is 1, and 1 inverted is 0. I'll copy the AND, OR, and exclusive OR truth tables to the bottom of the screen when we need them. As invert is rather trivial, I will not bother copying it. What we just saw are Boolean operators. We also have two bitwise operators to shift data. I'll explain both with an 8-bit value that I have written down in binary. I have a variable A with value 1011001. What this is in decimal is not important for this example. What happens to A when I say A is A, shift right 2? What happens is 2 bits are skipped, and then this bit will go here, this will go here, etc. The result will be 1011000. These 2 bits will disappear, and to the left zeros are added. Shift left works similar. By the way, we have a shorter notation for this statement, which I'll show with shift left. A shift left is 2. This statement is equivalent to the one above, with the obvious exception that it is shift left rather than shift right. You can compare this with A plus is 2 or A div is 2. This short operation also works for shift operators. This shift left will shift all bits left. So this bit will go there, this goes there, etc. Again, zeros are filled in, so the result will be 1100011. These shift operators can be real lifesavers, which we'll see later on. What can I do with these bitwise operators? Before I show that, I'll first put the promised truth tables on screen. We just saw that the normal operators work on complete variables. Let's see how those bitwise operators work. I'll show you 2 numbers in binary notation. If I OR them bitwise, the result will be 0 OR 0 is 0, 1 OR 0 is 1, 1 or 1 is 1, 0 or 1 is 1, 1 or 0 is 1, 1 or 1 is 1, 0 or 0 is again 0, and 1 or 0 is 1. When I end them together, the idea is similar. 0 and 0 is 0, 1 and 0 is 0, 1 and 1 is 1, 0 and 1 is 0, 1 and 0 is 0, 1 and 1 is 1, 0 and 0 is 0, and 1 and 0 is 0. The same with the exclusive OR, with which we saw that exactly one of the inputs must be 1 to get a 1. So here we'll get 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, and 1. With the invert, we saw that we only need one input, so the result here will be 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, and 1. Okay, but what can we do with this information? We can use this to perform various actions on individual bits. Let's see how. When we look at the truth table and we see input A as mask for selecting bits, then we see if the mask is 0, the result will be equal to input B. When we set the mask to 1, input B doesn't matter, the result will always be 1. In other words, by using a clever mask of 1s where needed, we can set individual bits. If we look to the AND operator, when the mask is 1, we see that the result equals input B. If the mask is 0, B no longer matters. The result will always be 0. In other words, with the same clever mask, we can reset individual bits. Finally, the exclusive OR. If the mask is 0, the result is equal to input B. When the mask is 1, the result is B inverted. So exclusive OR allows us to toggle individual bits. And of course, we already saw that the shift operators allow us to shift a sequence of bits left or right. Before I put all this into practice, I'll first show you how we can write these numbers down more easily. Previously, we used the numbers 1011, 0110, and 0010, 1100. What's the value of these numbers, and can't they be written a bit shorter? Previously, we saw that we want to use the bottom number as mask. If we start writing code, it's useful if we can write them down in a more compact form. In decimal notation, or base 10, which is the way we normally count in, the top number is 182, and the bottom number is 44. These numbers are computed as follows. The rightmost bit, or least significant bit, has value 1, the next has value 2, then 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and 128. To compute the value, you must add the values where the bit is 1. Thus, 128 plus 32 is 160, plus 16, 176, plus 4 is 180, plus 2 is 182. So to get the decimal number, you have to compute it, and it's not immediately obvious which bits are on and off. Luckily, there's a solution. We can write these numbers down in hexadecimal, or base 16. This means we have 16 digits. 16 digits can be coded into 4 bits, and as you might have noticed, I already grouped our 8-bit numbers into 2 groups of 4 bits. This means we can write these numbers as 2 hexadecimal numbers. How do we count in hexadecimal? First we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and then A, B, C, D, E, and F. When you code these digits binary, you will get 0000, 0001, 0010, 0011, 0100, 0111. And then all these numbers again with the first bit set to 1, 1000 and 1111. So if we write this number in hexadecimal, we will get 1011. 1011 or B, and this is 0110, which is 6. To the computer we say, read this as hexadecimal, which we do by adding 0x in front of the number. So this means hexadecimal and the number is B6. If you get used to this notation, you can quite easily see which bits are on. The bottom number is 0x2c. In the practical examples I'll show you in a minute, I will use hexadecimal notation. The practical use of bit manipulation. As example, I will use an 8-bit register from an RP6 robot, the MCTL register, and as promised, I'll put the truth tables and hexadecimal numbers back on screen. How can I set the SPI 3 bit in the MCTL register? Previously, we saw that we use an OR operator to set bits. SPI 3 is bit number 5. If I want to keep the original values of all other bits, I must use 0 for my mask. So my mask will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. If I want to set a bit, I must use a 1 in my mask, so this bit here will be 1. Here is the separation between both halves, so hexadecimal, this is 2-0, 0-0-1-0 and 0-0-0-0. Before I can use this, I will first have to read the MCTL register into a variable. What I need to do is often called a read-modify-write sequence. What you need to do is, first read the register value into a variable. How that is done is another topic. For now, I assume we have a read-register function. Then we have the modify part, reg, which we OR with hexadecimal 2-0, and then we write the value back into the MCTL register. Read-modify-write. And because I OR'd with this bit set, SPI 3 will now be 1. Another example, how do I reset the DRPD and STON bits? DRPD is bit 6 and STON is bit 4. These two bits need to be reset or set to 0. So I'll use the AND operator. We already saw that with AND we can keep our original values by using 1 in our mask. So in my mask I need 1s. Here I need zeros, as a 0 will reset my bit, so my mask is 1010 or A and 1111 which is F. So here I can say reg AND is 0xAF. Personally, I don't really like this, as in this mask I find it a little less easy to see which bits are on. So personally I prefer to write the inverse of 0101 0000. 0101 is 5 and 0000 is 0. So I prefer to write AND the register with the inverse of 0x50. With this 5 mask, I immediately know which bits in the left half will be set. By the way, we have a name for such a half byte, or 4 bits, a nibble. Next example. How do I toggle the mode bits? Mode is these two bits, and when I want to toggle them, we saw that I need exclusive OR with 1s in my mask. So my XOR, which is short for exclusive OR, mask will be 0000, 0011 or hexadecimal 03. Thus we can write reg XOR is 0x03. Final example. How do I read the status from two bits? For instance, status of the GLVL bits. To do this, I must read my register value, but I don't need to write anything back. After reading, I must do something, so I only see these two bits. This something is resetting all other bits. Resetting a bit is done using AND and a zero mask, or reg NS 0x0c. If I do this, I only have the original value in these two bits. The bad thing is, let's say these bits have values 1 and 0, which means that now reg contains 0000 1000 or hexadecimal 8. This doesn't really tell me what GLVL value is, so it's a good idea to shift reg 2 bits to the right. This gives me 0000 0010, which means I have the GLVL bits aligned to the right side of my variable. What often happens in software is that you need more than just the value of GLVL. You often need to know, is GLVL 0, 1, 2 or 3? GLVL has 2 bits, so it can have 4 different values. What do I do if I need to conditionally do something when GLVL has value 1 or 0,1 in binary? In this case, you can write down an if statement. If reg AND 0x0c, that shifted two positions to the right, If that's equal to 1, then we need to do something here. An alternative way of writing the same is reg shift height 2 and 0x03. 3 in this case, because we now need the two rightmost bits. Summary. How do I set bits in a register? By using a bitwise OR. How do I reset bits? By using a bitwise AND. How do I toggle bits? By using a bitwise XOR. And how do I read the status? By first using AND to reset all other bits, and then using SHIFT RIGHT to put the bits at the right spot. And if I want to set, reset or toggle bits, I need a read modify write sequence.